Hello, and welcome to a walkthrough of my latest game, Maze of Bears. Today, I'll be showing you some of the randomly generated levels. In other videos, I'll be showing you the puzzle levels, of which there are many, and they're all based on a different idea. I'll also be showing you the editor later on, where you can make your own levels and share them online. And today we'll be looking at the random play levels. So I shall pick a monster density of high because I like a challenge, and variety is high. And I'll leave the board style on random and then get started. So as the opening menu suggests, you basically have to avoid all the bad stuff and seek out all the good stuff, which is mostly yellow. So the game starts. Cats run away from you, as that cat's doing. I was going to run after it, but this spider's chasing me. Spiders move when you do, and they move like a chestnut. So if you plan what you're doing, they won't get you. But if you just run around like an idiot, they will definitely get you. But they're stupid enough to fall down holes. So I just tread on the crumble bit, and then if I can then lure it into the crumbly. I'll do that later. Right, there's a bonus to my right, which is the dig. So if I pick that up, I can now dig holes and things. Dig, dig, and then you can put blocks that you just dug. So I like to go around and store up a load of half blocks, because most of the enemies can't walk on the half blocks. Now, if I went to grab that gold beneath me, I would die. So I don't like those spiders, right? But a good way to get rid of spiders is you just run around next to where the holes are, and if they're stupid, they will fall down the traps. So yeah, I'll just ignore that. Right, I can get that cat. Now normally I'd be stuck, but I can press X to plant the block and then climb out. What's left? There's one cat left, so as long as those spiders don't chase me. Now, if I just plant a few of these, because they can't walk on. Right, okay, never fear, I shall get past level 1. More spiders! They're supposed to be randomly generated. I was going to like show you all the different animals, but we're just getting lots of spiders. Fortunately, they all fell down a hole, and that's fine. So we can concentrate on other things like the push. The push ability, as the name suggests, means you can push stuff. You can't push metal things. You can push things down the void. We have to be careful you don't push cats or gold down the void. We have turrets that shoot lasers at you. There's landmines, you've got to avoid those. There's man traps, again. And I wasn't concentrating then, I just jumped in and grabbed the cat, and realised that I'm now trapped in these four squares. Because if I go to the left, I get lasered, and if I go up, I get man trapped. So it looks like I'm going to die. Which animation shall I show you? The monitor. Yeah. Right, so level 2, not doing very well. A ball just pushed a cat down a hole, but it wasn't my fault, so I don't get penalised. Picked up the pull power, which is like the push power, but you can you have more control over it, so you can push a ball down a hole, etc. Right, the ice is slidey, so couldn't push to the right here. When I tried pushing, it wouldn't let me because that metal block over on the left was stopping me. I want to avoid that laser. You can push blocks into the water and then you can walk on them. Chests open up to reveal new powers, such as the scissors, the cloner power. So this one's nice. You hold down X and then you push in the direction of what you want to copy. And then you can just like copy and paste your way. And you can even copy and paste on top of things, on top of turrets. Or, for example, you might copy a turret and place it somewhere to trigger the laser to burn something. Don't have too many of those, so I'll copy some blocks on top of those. I'll copy the half blocks because I like those. You can just walk anywhere you like. That's about it for this level. That's quite a simple one. Right, what else have we got? Got a push. Now I'm tempted to get that gold, but the spider would get me. There's a tornado, that's a fun one. Shall I jump in? Yeah, go on then. Bit of a risk, but I'll give it a go. So when I get the tornado, I'll just press X. The tornado basically spins stuff around, but you have to avoid getting eaten. Right, slider, that's the best power for shaking. Slide stuff around in rows or columns. It's very handy. So, that spider is hunting me. You have to think things through a little bit with these. If I go if I get the spider in the same row as me, and slide it into the laser and deal with that little bubble. The wolf, I'll just free the wolf, so see how the wolves work. Basically they move at the same speed as you and they hunt you down and they absolutely will not stop until they hit a bear trap or a wolf trap. Cats, get some more cats. I wasn't really looking where I was going yet. If I go down and die, they don't move any faster. If I move left, then I can't get the gold because I'd be trapped in there. So I'll do X and then up to grab the block, and then move to the right. So now I'll do X and then down, push the wolf, and then you can't get me. There's a stealth bonus, I'll just grab that one. As soon as you get stealth, then wolves and bears and cats cannot see you. Spiders and hatchlings can still see you because they operate by sound, but if you get slippers then they can't hear your footsteps, and the light from the laser passes through you. So, level 3. Right, not looking a very easy starting off point. There's a landmine over there. If I quickly go across, trigger it. Now, I could jump down and get the dig to show you the dig, but I'd be stuck and I'd die, so I'm not going to. Let's find something else. Just trigger it. Freed up the dig, so now I press Z to dig a hole and X to place it. So you can dig your way through all this stuff and then you can place it back. So I like to build up a whole load of half blocks because nothing can walk that half block apart from a bowl. Cat food's good. Did there was dug a hole and then I jumped to the nearest safe spot which had a bull in it, so I got bored. So I only got as far as level 4 and felt like I didn't get to cover as many things as I wanted to. Never mind, but hopefully that just gives you a flavour of what the generated levels are like. Thanks for watching. In later videos I'll show you all the puzzle levels, how you can make your own levels, and play other people's levels and rate them and share them online. The free version of Maze of Bears is online now at mazeofbears.com, and you can unlock all the extra content for the cost of a sandwich. So have fun, hope you enjoyed it, and I'd be happy to hear any feedback. Thank you.